So when it comes to SUVs, there aren't many manufacturers that have a better reputation than Honda. That being said, no Honda SUV is perfect, and the Pilot has been in production long enough to have more than a couple of problem years. Maybe you've owned one and you have one in mind. If you're serious about getting a reliable and long-lasting SUV, you need to know the Honda Pilot years to avoid and why you should avoid them. Don't worry though, I've got you covered. Dave is here for you. I'll discuss the years you should avoid, the most common problems that make those models less consistent, and which versions of the Honda Pilot are worth your hard-earned income. So, if you're ready, I'm ready. Thank you for watching. I hope you subscribe. Let's dive in. The Honda Pilot years to avoid. Well, the Pilot got off to a little bit of a rough start with the 2003 release, which unfortunately has stuck to the model name for quite a while. Maybe you bought the first one. That being said, there are some model years that are much more consistent and some which aren't very reliable. Here are the Honda Pilot years to avoid, and then I'll talk about why we need to avoid them. Here they are. If you want to write them down, great. If not, I'll list them off. Rewind this, watch again. 2003, 5, 9, 11, 2013, and yes, 2016. Now, this list is relatively slim considering the Honda Pilot has been in active production since 2003. But as you can see, they had to work out some of the bugs in the design after that first release. It doesn't help that the early 2000s saw a lot of consumers, maybe you, concerned with the safety and efficiency of SUVs in general, which made it a particularly difficult time to release a new model SUV. Still, some of the issues with the Pilot were more than earned, let's be honest. Now let's talk about some of the common problems these models ran into. Again, take notes if you want to, otherwise you can always rewind. Here are some of the most common problems with the Honda Pilot so you can make an informed choice about which model you're willing to drive or buy again. Of all the problem Honda Pilots run into, the most serious is probably the transmission failure problem. Thankfully, this problem is mostly limited to the 2003 model year, though there are some isolated incidents of transmission failure in other Pilot models. Transmission failure is one of the most expensive repairs your car can need, so it's a serious commitment to take on a vehicle that has this as a known problem in its history. Worse transmission failures in traffic can make it hard to control a vehicle and may even result in a crash, God forbid. Excessive oil consumption is a relatively common problem among SUVs, and it's common in a few different model years of the Pilot as well. This isn't a huge issue as long as you know that your model might start to consume oil, especially after 100,000 miles, but it can be a serious issue if you don't know that it might happen, and now that you do, you'll be better prepared. The main problem is that low oil can cause engine damage and may cause your vehicle to overheat, but only if you let the oil get too low overall. So now you know, right? This can be managed by keeping a can of oil in your trunk and topping it off every couple of weeks, just like how you would manage an oil leak. You don't want to do that, but it's a good thing to know. However, over time, excessive oil consumption can burn a hole in your pocketbook and make your vehicle a lot harder to maintain. No way around that. Peeling paint is also a problem, mostly cosmetic, obviously, but it can cause more serious problems if you live somewhere with a lot of wet weather or where rust is a consistent issue. For the most part, I don't think that peeling paint is serious enough to stop you from buying a vehicle like a Pilot, but it's worth knowing that you may have to get it repainted at some point during your ownership. Recurring fault codes are usually more irritating than dangerous, except when a recurring fault code hides a real problem underneath. These happen when the sensors in your Pilot trigger on a non-existent issue. Recurrent fault codes can usually be spotted quickly, either by you or your mechanic, but the problems happen when you get a legitimate fault code after your Pilot has already trained you not to pay attention to them. In these cases, you may cause unintentional damage to your vehicle simply because you thought a legitimate fault code was another false alarm. All right, moving on to more issues and problems. Fuel injector failures are another common issue with your Honda Pilots, and they can be an expensive problem to fix. This issue is actually more common in recent model Honda Pilots, especially the 2016, so a few years back, which is a departure from the other issues that are more concentrated in early generation models. This issue is particularly troublesome considering it typically shows up around 60,000 miles, which makes it an early part failure for most vehicles. And since the price to fix it can be several thousands of dollars, this one issue you may want to research before committing to owning a Honda Pilot. So, okay, if you're looking for a Honda Pilot that's a little more reliable than the models already discussed, I like that, there are plenty to choose from. While the Honda Pilot has a few serious concerns, most of its releases have been very consistent and durable. Again, here's a list of numbers. I'll go through them somewhat fast, but keep in mind you can rewind this, but here we go. 2004, 6, 7, 8, 2010. Moving on to 2012, 2014, 2015, 2017, 2018, 2019, and 2020. Did I read that slow enough? All these options are durable, reliable, and have a very low incidence of the kinds of part failures and other issues that were serious problems for the older Pilot models. So, which Honda Pilot models are good to buy used? Looking for a used car is more than just looking for reliability. Looking for a used car means looking for something that can handle high mileage, lots of use, and that's been well maintained by its previous owners. Did you take care of your old vehicles? With that in mind, the 2010 model is a good option among older Honda Pilots. It's got a lot of the modern conveniences that were introduced in the 2009 model, but has some reliability improvements that make it a better long-term bet. Of more recent models, you'd probably be well served by almost any model between 2015 and 2020, with the exception of the 2016 release. Of course, anything even newer is gonna be better, but of course you don't have the long-term reliability and studies to back that up just yet. So did I miss anything? Are you a former Honda Pilot owner? Do you have any thoughts, feedback, any personal experiences you wanna share? If so, please subscribe and leave your comments below. I appreciate that. Thank you for watching. I'm Dave Erickson. See you next time. Adios. One final note, if you are in the market for a new vehicle soon, great. Connect with your local dealership and price and test drive at least 3 different vehicles. A vehicle's strengths and weaknesses can only be discovered when you are behind the wheel. My reviews can be good, but you need to test drive these yourself. Visit quotes.everymandriver.com, select the make, model, and your zip code, and you'll get invoice pricing in your area on those vehicles. Shop smarter with price quotes at quotes.everymandriver.com.
Thanks for watching.
Please click subscribe
and give us a thumbs up.
See you next time.